Why I Live Where I Do, a composition by Jenny Shepherd. Have you ever thought about why you live where you do? Is it for practical purposes such as jobs, closeness of family and friends, closeness of schools and shopping malls, or perhaps it is where you have always lived, or is it just because it's where you want to live? From the top of the hummock, which is the highest point near to Bundaberg, it is easy to see most of the reasons we, Alan and I, live where we do. To the east is the blue ocean, to the north, west and south, a multicoloured jigsaw of paddocks. The paddocks are many shades of green, the dark green of the mango and macadamia nut trees, the lighter greens of the tomatoes, herbs, strawberries, sugar peas and sweet potatoes, and the green gold of pineapple plantations. But the most prominent feature is the green yellows of the sugarcane. As it is now being harvested, large areas of the dark volcanic soil and what I call Northern Territory red soil are being exposed, and more frequent each week. As we leave Bundaberg and turn off to go the 16 kilometres along Moore Park Road, I call this area the Circle of Life. There is a noticeable change in the scenery each week. The most notable are the tomato farms. We watch the farmers plough many acres into furrows, then lay plastic before planting the new plants. Once the plants are established, the farmer uses sticks to support the plants as they grow in leaps and bounds. Flower, then fruit appears. As they colour, pickers are hired to select pick for weeks. Once all usable fruit has been picked, the plants are left to dry and die, the plastic lifted and the paddocks tilled ready for the next crop, which will start the cycle again. Three or four crops are produced each year. Currently, the 8-foot-high sugarcane, which encases the road, is being harvested, revealing acres of laser-leveled paddocks as far as the eyes can see. Equally, some eyesores are now in view, such as an area where the farmer has dumped all his old machinery. These days, the sugarcane is only burnt if it is diseased, but still, the spectacle of the long line of fire creeping through the paddocks would cause panic to the untrained eye. It's just like the yearly backburning done in forests. At night, the horizon is aglow with the amber colour of the flames, and the smell of burnt sugar fills the air. Between these farms are smaller ones producing herbs, roses, and other crops such as beans, snap peas, zucchini, pineapples, and so on. Some roadside stalls are erected, so there is no reason not to have fresh fruit and vegetables. Closer to home are the dark green macadamia nut orchards. The sun filters through these immaculately kept orchards, and it is hard to see the nuts. It takes 7 years before the nuts can be harvested during February to June. Sprinkled right along the road are really old mango trees in full flower. If the fruit holds, in a couple of months' time, it will be a massive harvest. Then their yearly cycle starts again. 5 kilometres before home is the Booyan turnoff to the South Kalan River. Wide and fast flowing, many people use tinnies to get up into the mangroves to catch the mud crabs, blue swimmer crabs, and course, fish for the elusive fish in the hope that they will catch dinner. Once we turn into our street, we can see and hear the ocean. The ocean is a story in itself. When the wind whips up, it becomes grey and angry as it mixes in with the sand and the foamy waves crash to shore. At high tide, this becomes a roar. Most of the time, the aqua blue water is calm, as we are protected by Fraser Island, and sometimes you have to strain to hear it. Either way, it has a very calming effect on people. The ocean sounds are magic when you are falling asleep or having a brisk walk along the beach on a windy day. Since we have lived here, I have begun to appreciate my surroundings more, especially the changing of the seasons. Just sitting here on my veranda, typing away, I can hear the ocean, the birds twittering in the trees, and the peace and tranquility which surrounds me. Jenny.